Nigel Farage. Well, he's a very dangerous man. And some people love him. They really do love him. I don't know why, but they do. They think he's fantastic. But anyone with half a brain cell knows he's just grifting you. Exactly what he's doing. But he does worry me. He worries me deeply. Because when I see what's going on here in France, although I think Macron might have played a blinder, I feel that Nigel Farage is going to be that Marine Le Pen. He's going to come up in the ranks eventually. Not this term, not this general election, but next. And we're going to see some major shifts to the right. And no matter what this new government, it'll be Labour or whoever it might be, or Monster Raven Loony Party, or maybe it'll be Camp Binface, I don't know. Whoever's going to be the next Prime Minister of the country, they are going to have to make some very difficult choices and make some very positive ones. Some big differences need to be made. If people don't feel better by the, not this general election, by the next general election, that they feel that the country's heading in the right direction, they will vote reform again. And this time, reform will have seats. They want this general election, but next, I mean, they will have seats. The Tories are going to have to go a very long way to resurrect themselves. They're going to be hovering around kind of Lib Dem type money, you know. Nigel Farage is dangerous. And the Labour Party, if they are the next government, they're going to have to spend some serious money. They're going to have to borrow. They're going to have to look and see where the money's been wasted as well. There's plenty of waste. Considerable amount of waste. Much of the waste is actually in the NHS. I'm not talking about staff, I'm talking about waste. I'm talking about procurement. But if we don't do something, or the government doesn't do something that changes people's lives for the better, I believe we're going to have a right-wing government. I mean, a government that has people in there who are Nazi sympathisers, people who think it's okay just to drown the people coming over the, such as Benny Beeb, coming over the channel, just drown them. So that's the kind of people you got in there. Is that who you really want to be associated with? Because that's what happens. People looking on around the world, don't they? Looking on the UK. Who are the first people they see? It'd be the King and the Prime Minister. And if the Prime Minister's allowing stuff like that going on, well, then it makes the whole country, look bad. They can feel that they don't want to deal with us, don't want to have trade deals with us. So, whatever happens, whoever's in charge, they are going to be increasing the national debt. Not by a little. But probably by quite a lot. I don't see where else they're going to get the money from. I really don't. And do I think it's the right thing to do? I think it is. We must invest in our infrastructure. We must make new jobs for people, good jobs. And expecting industry to do it ain't going to happen. Industry is there to make a profit. They'll do whatever they can to save money. That's called good business. Whereas a government who invests the money wisely, I'm not talking about handing out contracts to Tom, Dick and Harry. Well, that money should end up being recirculated into the wider economy. Not necessarily abroad, you see. It's a difficult one. But do you have faith in Starmer? Starmer? Crikey. To be able to pull it off? I've got my doubts. I really have. You tell me. Please leave it in the comments down below. But I'll leave you with this. You're only as good as the people you have around you. Oh, damn it. He's bugged. Toodaloo.